everybody. In today's tutorial, I'm going to go ahead and explain how to wear a wig so that it's both comfortable, easy fitting, and it won't really look like a wig as much. Now, there's about three things in total that you're going to need to do this. First of all, a wig, obviously. Next, you're going to need a wig cap. Now, I have two different varieties in my hands right now. The first one is a fishnet one. You can kind of see when I stretch it out. And it also has an opening on the top. And the other one is a nylon one. It's just a regular, simple, sealed up type one. And I'll explain the differences and also how to try both of them on. But the third item that you're going to need is some bobby pins. Now this is very important to have bobby pins. It makes it so it just doesn't slide around on your head. Now, first of all, I want to warn everybody, if nobody has noticed this yet, which I'd be surprised, I have very thin hair, which means that putting a wig on is a lot easier for me. If you have thicker hair, if you have longer hair, what I'm going to be showing you might not work completely, and I'll kind of explain what other options are available for you. Now, for me, when I put a wig on, all that I need to do is just put it in a low ponytail. Now, if you have longer hair, you might have to put it in multiple French braids or several different buns. I've heard of people actually putting it up in pin curls also. Whatever works best for you, go for it. Now, from here, I'm going to explain the nylon net fitting, and then I'll go into the fishnet one. Now, for the nylon net, you just need to tuck it onto your head. You will look silly. Tuck in any bangs that you have in the front. And then in the back, just grab all the hair and tuck it in. Up front, what I prefer to do is just put it right at my widow's peak and tuck it all down. And now you've got your wig cap on. Everything should be sealed in. I know it's a little bit messy here, but I'm going to be pulling it off. That's how you do this one. Now for the fishnet one, you don't even need to put it up in a ponytail. All you need to do is grab it, stretch it out, bring it over your entire head, and pull your hair out. So it's kind of like you're wearing a choker now. There we go. Now you're going to want to grab all of it and slowly bring it up and over your head. Again, I stop it at the widow's peak. Now, grab the top of it, and you'll notice all of your hair kind of falls right into that hole. Go ahead and ease it right in. And then what I like to do is just tuck it all in. So now you're all set. Your hair is all locked in place. This is really important because also with a net or either one of the wig caps, it actually gives a little more traction for the wig. Now you could go ahead and put your wig on. If you have pins holding it in place, remove the pins. Most wigs also come with little hooks on the bottom. And just right here, and they attach right in to some strips on the bottom. It's always good to get this wig to fit you first before even putting it on. And I do want to point out that on all wigs, there's this little L bracket on both sides near the top, which is where your ears are going to be resting. Now, a lot of people, or at least when I was first cosplaying, they just suggest grabbing the wig and just flipping it right over your head. It actually makes more of a mess if you do it that way. So instead, what I would suggest that you do is just hold on to the wig, flip it around, rest it at the top, then grab the back. I know it's a little hard to see and I'm sorry, but grab the back and pull it right down. Then from here, find those L brackets that I was talking about and adjust them so that they fit right across your ears. Now for me, my wig has really long bangs. So now you could sit here and kind of fidget a little bit with the wig to make it look good. Now, you just need to grab some bobby pins, which these guys are just blonde guys. I know they're not too visible, and I'm sorry. but they work well with a pink wig. I usually attach about 3 or 4 of them, and what I normally do is right behind my ear, I will just tuck it and push it right up. And if you get the wig cap, that's just fine. So I do those two. Sometimes if it's a wig that I know is going to be slipping on me, I will also do one at the very back. And then you could also do two at the front points if you need to. Now from here, go ahead and just spruce up the wig the way that you want it to look. For me with this wig, I always like putting a little headband on it. And you're all set and good to go. You can honestly sit here, bounce your head around, flip your head around, adjust it. It's not going to fall off. And it looks a little more realistic because then your widow's peak or just your hairline is gone. The wig cap will hold everything in place and the back of your head won't really bunch up so that you won't have this little bulb showing up that tends to happen if you put your hair in a bun and then put it in there. So those are the basics for being able to put a wig on, and I hope this does help out a lot of people. Good luck.